Hello, welcome to the Dugout Show. Here is where the magic happens. I sit there, Matthew sits over there. No one can top that magic. See you in the episode. Hello, welcome to another episode of the Dugout Show. And here we have some more breaking news of all the Boston local sports and the Bedford Buccaneers. Right, Matt?
Yep.
All right, so first is the Celtics. That was just a terrible game against the Raptors.
Sadly, yes.
They got destroyed in the second quarter. Like, I can never think I can top that. Of that much destruction.
Did you see that awful play?
Yeah, I did. When Nick Nurse is like, technical foul.
Yep.
On Jason Tatum. And then the ref is like, you're right. Technical foul too.
Yep.
Jeez. Well, Jason Tatum is going to be the next. Who has good raging issues?
I don't know.
Probably DeMarcus. Anyway.
Good point.
Oh, jeez. Well, the Celtics have gone on another drought. And by drought, I mean drought.
Yeah, 0-3 after the All-Star period.
Yep, and they're facing the Portland Trailblazers tonight.
You're right.
And, well, the standings keep getting higher and higher with the Milwaukee Bucks still in first and all the other teams pretty much in the same exact standings.
Let's just hope we can do good.
You're right. So, continuing, we have a new thing going on. We ask questions, and by we, I mean Matthew, and by Matthew, I answer his questions of true or false. All right, Matt, what's the question?
Okay, today's question for the Celtics is, drum roll, please. Gotta do it for another 15 seconds. Is his rating either, is it 60% or is it like the worst percent you can ever imagine?
Well, knowing Jason Tatum, like the worst percent ever? No, it's 60%.
You're saying it's true?
Yes, it is definitely true.
All right, that wraps it up for the Celtics.
Thank God. Well, I wasn't wearing a Michael Jordan shirt. Just cross it out.
Ignore that, people.
Yes. Let's continue with the Celtics. What do you think they need to improve on?
Probably their defense and not trying to get hit by people in the chin.
What do you mean by that?
Like last night, he literally got, Jason Tatum got hit by number 77 on the Raptors. Just hope their defense does well. And if they can shoot well, which they can, it's fine.
This time, Matt, we're going to ask one more question. And this time, can we have a true or false, please?
Wait until the next topic.
That is true. Very, 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 very true. And by any chance, the next topic is the Boston Bruins. How's that for an intro?
Okay, just go.
You're right. Anyway, well, the Bruins add Johansson to the roster. During the trade deadline, they had two forwards, so that's good because they needed forwards, and now they're going to have, well, they did have forwards, but now they're going to have more power off the bench.
We don't have Nix this week. He is not available right now, but please don't mind us being not smart. about the Bruins.
Yes, because we don't care about the Bruins. We care about TD Garden. Right. Right. There. Right, Matt?
Yeah.
So, what do you think about the Sharks game that the Bruins played? One, like, what, 4-1, 5-1?
4-1, and, yeah, that was quite the game, especially when, the Sharks, you remember that? And,
that hit? Sharks bait? Guys.
Yeah. He literally, like, held him. Isn't that, that was crazy. I believe one player got ejected, but the other player didn't.
It's because of the colliding. If you collide with one player and another player comes in, the second player gets ejected because of the late hit contact. I'm pretty sure.
Yeah.
Don't roast us in the comments if we don't know our hockey stuff. We don't care about hockey. We care about TD Garden, though.
Well, you don't really mean that.
That's true. Anyway, well, I don't know if we have any more for the Bruins. Let me just check.
Nope. Well,
no, so we'll add another true or false question. And Matt, just one thing. Try and make it a true or false this time, not like a yes or no, true or false. Like, true or false, is this team going to do well? Like that sort of thing.
That's basically like a prediction.
Yes, but I said a question like that.
Can the team be able to reach a good stage in the playoffs? Can they do it, or will they not?
Well, what do you mean by a good stage? Like, first, second, like, at least make the playoffs?
Yep.
Well, right now they're the second seed, and they want to stay that way, because they don't want to face, like, the Rays or the, like...
Tampa Bay.
Tampa Bay. Thank you. Don't roast us. And, like, Tampa Bay in the playoffs... Like, the first or second round. They want to face him in the conference championship.
That's exactly what I was, like, asking.
Yeah, because, like, what Nick said last week, this guy had, like, what, 600 goals or something?
The, like, 99 goals in, like, 66 games. I don't know.
True. Anyway, we move on to the next sport. Matt, do you know what that is?
The Red Sox.
Yay. Anyway, well, what do you think the addition of Pedroia will do for them? Would it, like, make them do good or do bad? Like the Celtics this year. How about that for an example?
Well, if he does well, and if he keeps doing well, getting better and feeling better, and if he just keeps practicing... he can do well.
That's true. Like, this isn't going to be another era of a long term. Right, Matt?
Oh, no.
No, because, like, this Red Sox team has every piece they need. Picture a puzzle. Picture a puzzle right here. They need every piece.
And he is one of them.
Yeah, I'm going to just take this Michael Jordan shirt away. So, Matt, why don't you talk about the Red Sox for a little bit? Well, I changed my shirt.
You still got your logo on the side of your shirt.
Why don't you switch to cameras and talk about the Red Sox for a little bit when I change the shirt?
No, thank you. Just wear it. Be proud.
I'm not a Chicago Bulls fan. Right, Matt? I'm not.
Well, let's just say that we have a new player, Ryan Johnson.
Left-handed pitcher?
Yep. Let's just hope he does well, like the other pitchers. I'm hoping if Chris Sale does well.
Chris Sale will always do well. He's Chris Sale.
Yeah, and like Craig Kimbrell and everyone else. So
I agree with that. Because definitely they got rid of Rick Porcello's contract and Drew Pomeranz's contract. So they have a little bit of open money during free agency.
Yep.
Let's see. Anything else for the Red Sox? No. So we move on, Matt. You know what?
True or false time.
Yes, sirree. All right, Matt. True or false question starts in 3, 2, 1, go.
Okay, wait. Do you want a real true or false question or a yes or no question?
True or false question for Reels Wheels. And make it like a history this time. Thank you.
History, okay.
Like a, I don't want to like give suggestions because I'll probably know the answer to them. But anyway.
Well, you love baseball.
That is true. So Matt, why don't we have the question 3, 2, 1, drum roll, please. And the question is,
are you literally just going to stand there like that?
Until the question, yes.
Why don't you talk about it while I think of one?
Okay, so if we think about like the history of the Red Sox, it's like this won't be like a bad era because like back then they had good teams, except Bill Buckner. Why don't we show a little montage of him?
No.
You're right. I'm sorry. Anyway, but yeah, but do you know what Bill Buckner was before then?
I don't remember.
He was a good player. Like, Matt, keep thinking of that question. He was a good player. Not only, like, fielding-wise, except for that error, but he could hit the ball, too.
Sorry. Yeah. Well, this is not really a true or false question.
Yeah, it's kind of close enough.
Who do you think could be the next Ted Williams?
The Ted Williams? Well, do you mean for the Red Sox playing right now, the draft, or free agency?
No, like, in all. Like, who do you think is looking like that person right now?
Right now, looking at it, is probably J.D. Martinez or Mookie Betts. Because, like, they both have the athleticism, but Mookie Betts, I think, has a better chance because he's more athletic. J.D. Martinez just hits home runs, but that proves how much strength he has.
He has more experience in the field than JD, but
you're right.
He got more home runs this you're time.
Right. You're right. Hey, Matt, give me a drum roll. And it's the New England. Finish my sentence.
Patriots.
There you go. So we'll talk about the NFL Combine now.
Well, we have about 350 participants.
Who do you think will come number one?
I have no idea. I mean, let's just see who does well.
That's true. And speaking of fast, do you see what Kyle Murray's draft prospect is?
Yeah. He's, it just depends what team he will do.
He's projected to go number 12. And I'm looking at these calculations. That doesn't seem right. Does that seem right to you?
It doesn't. However, whoever needs him will get him, but if someone doesn't need a quarterback, it would just be a waste.
Well, let's name the teams that need a quarterback. You have the Baltimore Ravens,
the Dolphins,
the Bears are good, 49ers,
Raiders,
definitely. So we have four teams right now. There's probably one more out there that we can't think of. Please don't roast us. Can you think of one?
I don't know. Thinking of people who don't need who need quarterbacks, so there's that's not really true. Much.
Well, we can draft. We technically need one because don't forget Brady's like what 41 years old.
Yeah, I mean Brian Hoyer's fine, but we don't have another QB.
That's
but
true.
But we're the last pick in the draft, number 32. So for the first round, so.
Yeah, but we have so many good players that we can trade for the number one overall pick.
Okay. So, now that the draft is coming up, who do you think the Patriots will get? And since it's the last, since they're the last pick in the first round, who do you think it will be?
Probably that Alabama quarterback. What's his name?
Jalen Hurts?
No, the other one.
Tua?
Yeah, Tua.
He's not going to go in the draft this year. He never announced it.
Well, I think he is. Maybe, maybe not. And, Matt, it's the end of the Patriots. You know what that means.
Question time.
Yay! Can I ask a question this time?
Sure.
Yay! How's that?
Great. Just ask the question.
Okay, ask the question. Do you want to... What type of question do you want?
Whatever.
I'll give you a multiple choice. All right, let's think. Oh, I got one. How many times did Adam Vinatieri hit clutch field goals? Is it A, 1, B, 2, C, 3, or D, none of those options?
I think it is C.
That is correct. During 2 Super Bowls and 1 to make the Patriots go to the playoffs, and that was during a snowstorm. Actually did it twice in that game, right?
Yep.
So technically, it's D! So you're wrong.
You just told me I was correct.
Either one of those would be fine. Either way. All right. So now we are on to our hometown team and loving team.
The Bucks.
Let me finish. And the and it's short for Tampa Bay. It's Buccaneers. But yeah, the Bucks. Anyway. So
but our Buccaneers.
So did you hear? Not only... But the girls' team made it out of the first round of the playoffs! Hallelujah!
Yes.
We don't know about the boys. We can check later. We'll inform you next week.
Sadly, I don't think they made it. But the girls, it's not the... it's definitely... It's the basketball team.
Yeah. And so they have the ice hockey season coming up. And Matt, why don't you switch the camera and go over to you for the skiing?
Nope.
Well, Bedford made it to a championship. Well, I think, do you have anything else to add?
Well, let's just say the skiing made it all the way to the championship. Congratulations. And the girls' team, too. Do you have any advice for them?
I have advice. Work hard, work as a team. Well, not like our team.
You just gotta do well.
Yep. So, do you have anything else to add?
Nope.
All right, that'll wrap it up for another show. See you next time.
Another episode complete. See you next time.
If we're still going. Not sure if we're still going.
Did you stop it on this?
Still going.
Well, did you stop it here?